such a wonderful day today, brothers and sisters. Can you feel the presence of our dearest Heavenly Father who's here with us at this very moment? Let Him reign in us.
Sunset sky, but my one request, Lord, my only aim is that you reign in me again.
Lord, reign in me, reign in your power over all my dreams. In my darkest hour, you are the Lord. To reign in me again.
Oh Father, may you always live within our hearts. Hallelujah.
Over every thought, over every word, may my life reflect the beauty of my Lord. 'Cause you mean more to me than any earthly thing. So won't you reign in me again, Lord, reign in me, reign in your power over all my dreams. In my darkest hour, you are the Lord of all I am. So won't you reign in me again, Lord, reign. Over all my dreams, in my darkest hour, you are the Lord of all I am. So won't you reign in me again? So won't you reign in me again? So won't you reign in me again?
Always believing in us. We are eternally grateful to you. 아주
Now brothers and sisters, let's put our hands together and sing praise of God and true parents. Let's sing together. Let's all stand up. Sing loudly.
You are holy.
You are mighty.
You are mighty.
You are worthy.
You are worthy.
Worthy of praise.
Worthy of praise.
I will follow.
I will follow.
I will listen.
I will listen.
I will love you.
I will love you.
Once again, sister first.
You are holy.
You are holy.
You are mighty.
You are mighty.
You are worthy.
You are worthy.
Worthy of praise.
Worthy of praise.
I will
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we have gathered here today for our Sunday service. After moving here to Jeongbokgung in March, and in April this month, we started our international services. We're so grateful that we could gather together with our brothers and sisters here and our brothers and sisters around the world. During this time today, we pray that you can give us a chance to reflect on this past week, what we have experienced, what we have learned, what we have learned that we need to learn. And we can prepare for the upcoming week, that what we hear today in the service can help us to be ready for our next week and for our future. We pray that you can be with us now and speak with us through the speakers. Speak with us and help us to understand your heart, to understand True Parents, to understand what you and True Parents want for us to do. And we pray that you can be with us during this upcoming week as we try to do those things. And also help us to be with our brothers and sisters and support them and help them, especially those who couldn't be here today, who had something which kept them away. Let us help connect them to you during this week also. We want to offer this time to you in the name of our blessed brothers and sisters around the world. Aju.
Good evening, brothers and sisters. Good evening, brothers and sisters. Welcome to the headquarters of Unification Church. It is so good to see you all. Today, we sincerely hope and pray that we fully inherit the true love of God and we truly know the meaning of Ascension Sungha ceremony as Father, True Parents are doing national tour. Let us all bring and return all the glory and gratitude to our Heavenly Father and True Parents. God bless you. Thank you.
Good evening, brothers and sisters. Welcome to the international service. Yes. Oh my God. You know, I have to say this. You guys have, you know, just a couple of you. You make more praise, joy, noise than thousands of members, you know, sometimes. I love our brothers and sisters from Korea. Brothers and sisters, let's manifest a principle. Give and receive action for a position foundation. May I inherit the true love of God. Today we're going to look at Chun Sungkyung 640. And Father speaks, he says, what is the one thing to be done in the world of humanity? The light of love must be bright. For that to happen, you must catch fire internally and externally. From what? The motive force to love. The motive force to love. Brothers and sisters, as you may know, Father has begun the new Chungi Wanyan calendar. And that is the new calendar centered on the new history that is being made. And so in conjunction with that, also at the Jeongbokgung, we will be actually, right now, presently, we have seven regions, okay, main regions. And starting from this week, it's going to be shifting from seven regions to four regions. And that is to simplify the understanding of which region one is in. So we have the city of Seoul now divided into north, south, east, west. It's much more simple than the seven regions, which were much more complicated and much more rational. So we will be switching to a four-region Jeongbokgung. And next week we will have the voting for our women leadership representing those four regions. Today in the earlier services we introduced to those four the ministers and hunsanims that will be responsible for the respective regions. And we'll hear a little bit about that, I believe, at the end of the service. We'll just have a couple slides about that at the end. But this is also so that our new members that come in can truly inherit the true love of God. And as Father said, the motive force to love, right? How we must catch fire internally, externally, and that is the motive force to love. Not just to receive love, it is to love. That is the verb. That is to go out into society and to love and to bring people before the Christ that has returned so that people can find everlasting life and love and lineage. So this is the real reason why we will be switching to the four-region system. Brothers and sisters, let's all rise and we will now recite the family pledge number 8. Let's recite the family pledge number 8. Our family, the owner of Chunyaguk, pledges having entered the completed testament age to achieve the ideal of God and human beings united in love through absolute faith, absolute love, and absolute obedience, and to perfect the realm of liberation and complete freedom in the kingdom of God on earth and in heaven by centering on true love. Achoo. Let's manifest the principle in a greater way today. Let's begin by stretching our hands down toward the sanctuary. Let's breathe in the universal prime energy, breathing in. Let's stretch up all the way towards the heavens today. Breathing out, give and receive action. Breathing in deeply, forward position foundation. Breathing out, lifting up towards the heavens today, stretching towards the heavens, mind, body, and spirit. Breathing in, may I inherit. And breathing out, the true love of God. Achoo. Brothers and sisters, let's all be seated. We usually have a brief meditation period now, but today we had one of our leaders was by Father asked to take over and lead the VOC. Our Kyogujang here, our regional director, Idongwan Kyogujang, who was the regional director for the headquarters church for about 2 years now, was asked by Father to now go lead VOC and the Kungmin Yonhap, that is, I guess, the Federation for Citizens of the Nation, and in English. And so our Idongwan Puejang will go there and take responsibility there. And one of our Hunsanims, Kim Gamnyong Hunsanim, who's actually in the back, will be the new regional director. Let's give him a warm round of applause. As you know, he's one of the Hunsanims who have passed the 400-day training. No skipping, no getting sick. You miss 3 days, you go back to one. After 33 years of ministry, then after they retire, the Hunsa track is open to qualified ministers who then can go through the 400-day period training. They train with us in the mornings. And Kim Hunsanim has been training with me actually since we've been at Mapo. He was the minister that was there for all the way from Mapo. So, wonderful minister, great experience, and I believe he'll be a great regional director. Brothers and sisters, now let's take time for prayer. I'd like to ask you all to extend your prayers, actually, for those two brothers that are having mission change. The regional director who will now be going to VOC, that is Victory Over Communism, his name is Lee Dong-han, and our new regional director, Kim Gamnyong. So if we can join our hearts in prayer to pray for their success and pray that they can return great glory to parents. Let's take the time to do that brief prayer and also extend our prayers to our other brothers and sisters around the world. Let's take this time for prayer. We'll pray in unison together. Dearest most beloved Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this day.
Rain.
things. Heavenly Father, we pray for ingratitude that you have protected us in the past week, that you have blessed us with the so many blessings that we have received. And Father, we pray all these things, the great blessings that you extend, that you may extend to the rest of our Unification family all over the world. We pray this in our own names as Central Blessed Families. Thank you, brothers and sisters. Brothers and sisters, let's all rise, and now is the time to greet your neighbor. See the person next to you? If you've seen them every week, that's fine, because now is the time to see them new, with new eyes. Give them a hug. Thank you. Bless you. God bless. Bless them this day.
Brought to the light by the grace of God and true parents, and we are ever so grateful for their true love. Let's celebrate this time together and know that Papa truly feels to be free.
There's one that has been standing since the day that Adam fell. Sin is where it started, sin is white hell. Speaking as a prisoner who was there and lived to tell, I remember how it felt.
I can hear the sound of freedom like a distant voice call, beckoning me to follow where I have never gone. through my heart was feeling. I just threw that at the wall. Somehow we fall.
But into love I found the doorway, and hand that had the key. When the chains fell at my feet, for the first time I could see.
This is how it feels to be free. This is what means to know that I am forgiven. This is how it feels to be free. To see that life can be more than I imagined.
This is how it feels to be free, yeah.
This is how it feels to be free.
Was in, like a living nightmare, burning deep within. I can feel the voice of evil, I can hear the call of sin, but I won't go back again. See, once I taste the freedom, then the chains could bind no more. Mercy gave me wings to fly, like an eagle I can soar.
How it feels to be free. This is what means to know that I am forgiven. This is how it feels to be free. To see that life can be more than I imagine.
This is how it feels to be free. Yeah.
This is how it feels to be free.
The chains feel
by,
never for the grace of God, just want to still be mine.
So for all the captives I say, this is how it feels to be free. This is what means to know that I am forgiven. This is how it feels to be free. To see that life can be more than
Come bless the Lord.
Come bless the Lord.
the Lord always. And again I say, rejoice in the Lord always. And again I say, rejoice in the Lord always. And again I say, rejoice.
Declaration. Let's join our hands together. True Parents Declaration. These are my true parents, the eternal King and Queen of Peace and Liberator of God's heart. They have saved me from my past, they have blessed my future, and they give me true love, forgiveness, and happiness today, and I choose to receive them. My mind is awake, my heart is open wide, and from this moment I change forever. In my name, Aju. Thank you, Mrs. Please be seated. Brothers and sisters, today we have a wonderful guest speaker. Oh, you must have heard a little bit, I think, some of you. Maybe you heard the from the grapevine. We have a wonderful speaker today, our Chaitanya Sajangnim, the chairman of our Tonga group here in Korea, will be speaking for us today. Before he speaks, we have the our PR director from the Chaedan. His name is Mr. An Yo-il Shil-jung, and he will give a brief presentation about the issue that Kuk Jin-hung will speak about today. And then we'll see a brief video expounding on that issue, and then Kuk Jin-hung will be able to speak. So when Mr. An comes up, let's all invite Mr. An up. And when he comes up, let's give him a big round of applause as he comes up to speak before us. Come, yay, 들어오세요.
Hey, 여러분, 안녕하세요.
Hello, everyone.
예, 제가 영어가 발음이 안 좋아서 여러분이 못 알아잡을 것 같아서 할 수 없이 통역을 쓰도록 하겠습니다.
Mr. Ron says his 예. English pronunciation is not perfect and that you may not be able to understand him, and so he's using 네. a translator.
여러분, 우리는 지금 전쟁 중에 있습니다.
Right now, we are at war.
무슨 전쟁이냐? 납치 감금에 대한 전쟁입니다.
This is a war against abduction and confinement.
최고의 사탄이가 하늘의 아들을 딸들을 잡아갔습니다.
The biggest satans have taken the sons and daughters of heaven.
이것이 소위 전쟁입니다.
And so this is a war.
이 전쟁을 우리는 반드시 승리해야 합니다.
And we must win this war.
40년 가까이 사탄이가 하늘의 아들 딸들을 잡아가서 감금하고 구타를 했습니다.
The sons and daughters of heaven and has been confining them.
40년 동안 끌려간 형제 자매들을 우리는 반드시 다시 찾아와야 됩니다.
And we must find and bring back these brothers and sisters who were taken like this.
그동안에 갔던 것 이상의 보상을 받아서 우리는 찾아와야 됩니다.
And these victims must be compensated and we must recover all the money that was taken in this course.
이 찾아오기 위해서 세계 회장님과 국진 이사님께서 다양한 전략과 전술을 쓰고 계십니다.
And right now the international president and the chairman of our foundation are using a number of different strategies and tactics in order to accomplish this victory.
그 전략과 전술 중에 하나가 언론 플레이입니다.
And one of these strategies tactics is the work with the media.
예. 그래서 지금 현재 일본 부인회를 중심으로 해서
Centering on the Japanese Wives Association
일본 대사관 앞에서
here in Korea,
시위를 했습니다.
There was a demonstration in front of the Japanese Embassy in Seoul.
시위했을 때 AP를 비롯해서
And when that happened,
MBC,
the Associated Press, and Reuters, and NBC, the Korean television station, and other many other media were there to cover it.
예, 우리의 진실을 알기 시작했습니다.
And they began to understand the truth about our organization.
일본에 있는 에리카와 회장님과 다나카 회장께서 대사관 앞에서 절규했습니다.
And Mrs. Erikawa and Mrs. Tanaka, representing the victims, cried out in front of the embassy.
우리가 무슨 죄가 있느냐?
What have we done wrong?
우리는 한국을 사랑하고 일본을
Korea,
사랑한 죄밖에
we love Japan,
없다.
And that's all that we have done wrong.
우리는 구세주 메시아 재림주 평화의 왕이신 문선명 총재님을 구세주로 모시는 죄밖에 없다.
The only thing we have done wrong is to attend Reverend Sun Myung-moon as the Lord of the Second Advent, the Savior and the Messiah.
그런데 왜 일본의 악덕 기독교와 좌익 변호사들은
these ministers and Christian ministers in Japan and also
우리 신자들을 잡아다가
communist lawyers
감금하고
have taken
폭행하고
Unification Church members and have confined them, have beaten them.
거기에는 자살한 사람도 생기고 성폭행을 당한 사람
even some
또는 낙태를 당한 사람도 생겼습니다.
Sisters have been raped.
이것을 일본 부인 회원들은 대사관 앞에서
the Japanese
대사를 향해서 호소를 했습니다.
Cried out to the Japanese ambassador in their demonstration in front of the embassy.
일본 부인들이 화가 난 것은
What really makes the Japanese wives angry
이런 납치 감금의 주도 세력을 일본 정부가
is that the Japanese government
무기하고 있기 때문입니다.
is ignoring the fact that this is going on and is doing nothing about it.
일본은 종교의 자유가 있고 경제가 부흥한 일본 나라인데
Japan is a rich country and it is
a major power in the world. 무기인하고 있는가?
And yet this democratic country is ignoring this kind of abduction and confinement.
하는 데 대해서 강력히 항의했습니다.
Strongly protested this fact.
그래서 여러분이 보시는 화면처럼
So as you see here in the AP these were photographs taken by AP.
다음에 로이터에서
And Reuters
많은 부분을 기사화했습니다.
And they went there that day and they covered this and wrote these articles and took these photographs.
한국의 조선일보
This is the 조선일보 the Korean newspaper and 중앙일보 the major Korean papers also covered it.
경향신문에서
경향신문 as well.
일본 회원들의 절규하는 모습을 담아서
They talked about this the way that the Japanese wives cried out to this and they wrote their articles on that.
경제지에서
And here are the business papers.
세계일보에서
세계일보
이사장께서 특별히 지시하시어서
particularly the chairman of the foundation asked
가라.
the Sega Times to have a series of articles on this matter.
4회 이상 계속
And they've written four articles so far, and they will continue to write it.
그리고 이 일이 해결을 될 때까지 세계일보는
until this is resolved,
매주 1회씩
the 세계일보 plans to
그래서 일본의 아픔을
write one article a week,
전 세계에 알리고
so that just all the world,
한국 국민에게 알리도록
and all the people of Korea can understand
the
situation that is going on.
주위에서 혹자들은 영감상법에 대해서 고민을 했습니다.
Some people argued or were concerned about the fact that the Unification Church of Japan has been accused of spiritual sales.
그러나 이사장님께서는
But the chairman of foundation has said very strongly.
인권 탄압과는 비교도 할 수 없는 부분이다.
Even if that were true, it was not comparable to what has been going on.
낙태를 당하고 성폭행을 당하고 자살을 한 사람의 생명과 비교할 수 있느냐?
How can that be compared with sisters being raped and with people committing suicide in confinement?
이 프로젝트는 한 개인이 하는 것이 아니라
하나님께서
것이요 참 부모님께서 직접 진리하시는 것이다.
God is doing and that true parents are leading directly.
절대 선한 조상들이 적극적으로 협조할 것이다.
And our good ancestors are aggressively and actively cooperating in this effort.
걱정하지 말고 하라.
And so the chairman said, "Don't worry. Go ahead and do this."
그래서 협회 김종관 실장
So Mr. Kim Jong-kwan and the church headquarters,
전복궁의 이 실장님,
and Mr. Lee and 전복궁,
성교본부의 조성일 실장님,
and Mr. 조성일 and the World Mission Department,
이렇게 머리를 맞대고 고민하고
and also Mr. An got together and figured out how to do this.
그래서 한국의 언론들이 동조하기 시작했습니다.
And then the Korean media began to take our side in this matter.
여러분 한국의 가장 유명한 통신이 연합통신입니다.
The most famous wire service in Korea is the Yonhap News.
이 연합통신에서 여러 차례
and they have often covered this
with the
and sent this material out to all the news organizations in Korea.
여러분 에리카와 회장께서 설교하시는 장면입니다.
Mrs. Erikawa is on your right and she is crying out holding a photograph in her hand.
일본에서 한국에 시집온 일본 부인들이 7천 명에 달하는데
There are 7,000 Japanese wives who have married Korean men and are now living
in Korea.
And 300 of them
일본에 있을 때 납치 방문을 당했었다.
Were victims of abduction and confinement.
지금도 그 사람들은 일본을 돌아가지 못하고
Many of them are still not able to go back to Japan.
10년이 넘도록 15년이 되도록
10, 15 years after they have come to Korea.
한 번도
Because
고향을 가본
they've never
적이
been
없다.
Able to go back to their home.
이것은 우리가 가기 That's 싫어서 안 가는 것이
not
아니라
that they don't want to go,
납치 감금자들을
but because there
일본
still
정부가 방조하고 those, 있기 때문이다.
There are still people who are working this abduction and confinement and the Japanese government is letting it continue.
그리고 저 사진을 들고 보여주면서 기자들에게 호소했습니다.
And she held up that photograph and cried out to the reporters who were there.
저 사진은 단순한 사진이
this
아니라
This is not just any old picture.
이 여인은 한국에 시집 와서
This is one woman, Japanese woman who married a Korean man and she came to Korea and was living with that Korean or the Korean husband.
감금자들에 의해서 감금이 되어서
But when she went back to Japan to visit her home, she was abducted and confined.
고통과 고통을
And then she suffered so much during that confinement that she
그 억울함과 분함을 견디지 못해서
She was not able to endure the humiliation that she received and she took her own life in confinement.
이 여인은 자살한 게 아닙니다.
But that is not a suicide.
납치 감금자들이 살인을 한 것입니다.
When a person dies like that in confinement, this is murder committed by the abductors.
호소했습니다.
This is what how Mrs. Erikawa cried out to those reporters.
21세기 지구상에서
In 21st century, on this earth,
이런 일이 과연 일어날 수 있습니까?
How can this kind of thing be going on?
우리는 절대 납치 감금자들을 용서할 수 없습니다.
Allow this to continue. We cannot forgive those who are doing this.
우리는 반드시 그들을 찾아올 것입니다.
We will resolve this situation and bring back everything that was taken.
라고 호소를 했습니다.
This is what Mrs. Erikawa said.
그 옆에 다나카 회장께서는
Mrs. Tanaka was standing next to her. She is president of the Victims Association in Korea. And now 10, 15 years she's been living in Korea. Now her children are growing up.
할머니를 보고 싶고
children want to,
want
to go to their grandparents, want to see their grandparents.
라고 해도 우리는
But
she
says that we cannot go.
우리는 아무런 죄가 없습니다.
We have done nothing wrong.
우리의 죄는
our sin
일본을 사랑하는 것이고
to
한국을 사랑하는
to love Korea,
양국을 사랑하는 죄밖에 없다고 호소했습니다.
She's cried out.
그 내용들이 많은 매스컴을 통해서
this content was,
전 국가에 전 세계에 전달이
was covered by the journalists there and was sent out across the world.
그래서 경향닷컴에서는 약 5분에 가까운 동영상
in the online site of 경향신문 경향닷컴 they put up a 5-minute video.
이 신문은 and this is news of 천지
this is a weekly paper operated by a religious organization in Korea.
다른 종단이지만 This is 기독교의 문제이기 때문에
not our group, but they are another group, and they, because it is a Christian issue, they are also Christian. They handle this.
여러분 이것은 단순한 납치 감금의 문제가 아니라.
This is not just a simple issue of abduction confinement.
정말 우리는 사탄이를 용서할 수
So we cannot forgive Satan.
일본에서 하나님의 권위와 참 부모님의 권위를
God's authority and the authority of true parents must be reestablished.
역사적인 소명인 것입니다.
In Japan, that is. The mission to which we are being called.
그런 소명적 책임을 지시고 세계 회장님과 재단 이사님께서
international president
앞에서 진두지휘하고 계시는 것입니다.
Foundation chairman have calling us to this mission, and they are leading us in the forefront.
이 장면은 일본 부인 회원들께서
photograph you see is of the Japanese wives demonstrating in front of the Japanese embassy wearing kimono.
그다음에 시위하는 장면을 기자들이 취재하는 장면입니다. 여러분 우리는 이제 여기서 끝나지 않고 1단계, 2단계, 3단계로 접어들어서
second stage, third stage,
저희들이 처음에 출발할 때는 우리 모두가 다 삭발을 각오하고라도
so even if we all have to demonstrate in front of the embassy and even if we have to all shave our heads and protest we will completely be victorious in this issue.
일본 부인 회원들도 마찬가지입니다.
Same with the Japanese wives.
여러분 보시면 우측은 기자들이고 좌측은
This is the reporters on the right and the demonstrators on the left.
정말 시위하는 일본 부인보다도
The media had such great interest in this that there are actually more reporters there than there were demonstrators.
우리들의 억울함에 귀를 기울이기 시작했습니다.
Now they are listening to what we want to say.
이 장면은 에리카와 회장과 타나카 회장께서
This is Mrs. Erikawa and Mrs. Tanaka.
지지 서명을 받은 서명서를 들고
They are carrying the petitions and the support signatures to support the petition and they are going to, and they are delivering this to the Japanese embassy.
시위하러 갔을 때 많은 버스들로 접근을 막았습니다.
They blocked the entrance to the embassy so that the demonstrators could not get too close.
그러나 거기에 굴하지 않고 진행을 했습니다.
But we were able to deliver the petitions here, as you see.
이것은 대사관 앞에서 지지 서명서를 전달하는 장면입니다.
This is the place where the Mrs. Erikawa and Mrs. Tanaka are delivering the petitions to the Japanese embassy, and the reporters are covering that moment.
이 시위했을 때 경찰들, 일본 대사관 직원,
and the
그다음에 일본 특파원들도 많이 나와서
employees and Japanese correspondents were also there covering this.
그리고 난 이후에 에리카
And after this, Mrs. Erikawa was interviewed on the spot by AP and Reuters.
장면이 되겠습니다. 이어서 그리고 이제 두 번째
And second,
4월 23일 날 지난주 수요일 날
And last Wednesday, on April 21st,
프레스센터에서 기자회견이 있었습니다.
In the press center, there was a, we also had a news conference there in the press center.
일본 부인의 250명이 모여서
250 Japanese wives gathered there for the news conference.
어깨대를 두르고
They had, wear, wore their sashes and they were wearing their kimono and with a prayerful heart they attended that news conference.
이 자리에서 에리카 회장님은 40년 동안에 4,300명이 납치당됐다.
4,300 of our members have been abducted and confined.
이것은 도저히 있을 수 없는 일이다.
Cannot happen.
라고 기자들에게 호소를 했습니다.
And she cried out this way to the reporters.
이어서 고토 도루상도
Mr. Goto Toru
12년 5개월 동안
who was confined for 12 years
내가 어떻게 고통을 당했는가? 내가
spoke to the reporters about his experience, about his suffering during that time.
호소를 했습니다. 여러분 고토 도루상이 어떻게 감금을 당했는가?
And how was he confined?
저것은 고토 도루상이 납치 감금돼 있었던 아파트가
This is the
되겠습니다.
Apartment building where he was confined.
가족이 다른 집이
the
있었지만 그
family
집을
had
버리고
another home, but they rented this apartment
저 높은
specifically
고층 아파트를
for the purpose of keeping him confined on the top floor of this
저기에다가
apartment.
저기에다가 감금시켜 놓고
and they kept him there.
구타도 했고
and the son, he was beaten.
먹을 것을 주지도 않았습니다.
He was not fed properly.
경찰에 신고를 해도 오지를 않았습니다.
He called out to the police while he was there, while he was being taken there, but they did not help him.
겉도르상은 할 수 없이 30일 단식을 했다고 그랬습니다.
He figured that the only way he could resist, the only way he could protest was by going on a fast.
이것은 겉도르상 한 개인의 문제가 아닙니다.
But this is not just his individual issue.
우리 모두의 아픔이요.
A pain that we all share together with him.
모두의 서글픔입니다.
And it is our common sorrow.
겉도르상은 뛰어내리고 싶었지만 너무 높아서 뛰어내릴 수 없었다고 그랬습니다.
But he was so high that he could not do that.
도망을 가고 싶어도 도망을 갈 수 없었다고 그랬습니다.
And he could not go out the front door either, because as you see, there were.
왜냐하면은 저 많은 열쇠가 채워져 있었기 때문에.
This is how the front door was locked, double and triple locked.
하나도 아니고 하나 둘 셋 이상의 열쇠를 채워서 그들을 도망 못 가게 만들었습니다.
And so everything was arranged in that apartment so that he could not escape.
여러분 이것은 겉도르상 개인 한 사람만이 아닙니다.
This is not just one person that had this experience.
4,300명이 이런 아픔과 고통 속에서
have experienced this pain and this suffering.
교회를 못 나오는 자도 있고
and some are not don't feel that they can return to the church.
이미 영계에 간 자도 있습니다.
And some have gone to spirit world already.
우리는 이것을 반드시 해결할 것입니다.
But we need to resolve this situation.
이것도 열쇠입니다.
This is the lock that was on the window.
이렇게 많은 열쇠를 채워놓고
This apartment was arranged with all these locks.
때로는 청년들이 달려들어서
so that he could not escape. And sometimes young people would come.
악덕 기독교 목사들이 달려들어서
evil Christian ministers would come.
고통과 아픔을 주었습니다.
Give him to torment him and to beat him.
여기서 겉도르상이 분개한 것은
what Mr. Goto was truly angry about
기독교 목사와 좌익계 변호사가
ministers and these leftist lawyers
자기 부모를 속이는 데 분개했습니다.
Fooled his parents into going along with this kind of thing.
왜냐하면 우리 교회를 음해했기 때문입니다.
They defamed our church to his parents.
그것을 묵인한 일본 정부를 분개했습니다.
And he's also angry about the Japanese government that has allowed this kind of thing to go on.
이 문제를 해결하기 위해서 이사장님께서 일본을
now,
왕래하시면서
the foundation chairman when he was doing was working in Japan now to resolve this situation.
직접 진두지휘하고 계시는 것이
leading this effort directly.
이것 또한 기자회견하는 장면이 되겠습니다.
This is another view of the news conference last Wednesday.
여러분 이분은 이제 일본에 있을 때 납치 감금되었던
is a victim of abduction confinement when she was in Japan.
상황을 소개하는 장면입니다.
And she is reading out a statement of how what of her experience.
이런 분이 한두 분이 아니고
these are not just one or two like this.
한국에 300명 이상이 살고
계십니다. More than 300 Japanese wives now living in Korea had this experience when they were in Japan.
우리는 반드시 이 300명이 고향을 갈 수 있도록
We must make sure that all these 300 people are able to visit their homes.
여러분의 기도가 필요하고
We need your prayers.
여러분의 정성이 필요합니다.
And we need your 정성.
이어서 한국에 오셔서
Mr. Goto came to Korea last week and he was interviewed by weekly papers and publications.
브레이크 뉴스에서 10분 정도를 인터뷰를 해서
filmed this interview for about 10 minutes and made about a 10-minute video and placed it online.
그다음에 일본 부인들의 이름을
모아서 also the Japanese wives have put together petitions a petition to the President of Korea, President Myung-bak Lee of Korea. And also to the Prime Minister of Korea.
And
he also sent it to parliamentarians, members of the National Assembly in Korea.
이사장님께서 다양한 전술을 구사하도록 말씀하셨습니다.
The Foundation President has told us to come up with a variety of strategies for this effort.
이번 주에 한국의 국회의원 한 분이 대사를 직접 만나서
One member of the Korean National Assembly this week is planning to meet the Japanese ambassador, and when he does, he's going to file a formal complaint about this situation on our behalf.
Yeah. 예, 내용은 같습니다.
This is part of the material that was sent to the President of Korea.
예, 방송실 잘 안 넘어가네요. 예.
And these are petitions that are being sent to others, high officials in Korea.
이것도 똑같이 탄원서를 제출한 내용이 되겠습니다.
To various VIPs.
And now, 여러분 이제 그동안의 통신과 신문에 나왔고,
and, you've seen the wire services and how it was covered
MBC,
in the newspapers.
SBS,
that, the three major broadcast companies in Korea also covered it, NBC, KBS, and SBS, and we will take a look at those
같이 보시겠습니다.
Those reports. And I'll give you a running translation.
일본 통일교인 납치 감금 대책위원회는 오늘 오후 일본 대사관 앞에서 기자회견을 열고 일본 통일교 신자에 대한 납치 감금 문제를 국가 차원에서 해결해야 한다는 내용의 탄원서를 제출했습니다. 이들은 1966년 이후 통일교 신자들을 납치 감금한 사례가 4,300여 건에 이르는 것으로 집계됐다며 종교의 자유가 헌법에 보장된 일본에서 단지 신앙이 다르다는 이유로 인권을 탄압당하고 있다고 주장했습니다. 일본 통일교인 납치 감금 피해자 대책위는 오늘 기자회견을 열고 통일교로 개종했다는 이유로 일본에서 통일교인을 납치 감금하는 사례가 빈발하고 있다고 주장하고 한국과 일본 정부의 사태 해결을 촉구했습니다. 대책위는 1966년 통일교인 납치가 처음 발생한 뒤로 현재까지 4천여 명의 일본 통일교인들이 납치나 감금을 당했다고 밝혔습니다.
일본 통일교인 납치 감금으로 인한 한국 인권 피해자 대책위는 한국 남성과 결혼을 가정으로 일본 부인들이 납치 감금이 두려워 동양 방문조차 못하고 있다며 한국과 일본 정부의 사태 해결을 촉구했습니다. 대책위는 기자회견을 갖고 1966년 통일교인 납치가 처음으로 발생한 뒤로 현재까지 4천여 명의 일본인들이 납치 감금을 당했다고 주장했습니다.
예, 여러분 여기까지입니다. 이 프로젝트가 반드시 성공할 수 있도록 여러분 기도해 주시고 정성 들으시길 부탁드리면서 이어서 동영상을 하나 보도록 하겠습니다.
And now we will watch together a video about the demonstration in front of the embassy. This is the Japanese embassy. This is the Japanese embassy in Seoul. And the Japanese wives are gathering here, preparing for their demonstration. This is a news conference and submission of petitions by victims of a reduction in confinement and a violation of human rights of Unified Church members in Japan. And first, this is Mr. Noda, who is the Secretary General of the Victims Association in Korea. And first, they're singing a holy song. You're not just Japanese women married to Korean men. We are victims of abduction and confinement by those whose purpose was to force us to give up our faith. Such incidents began in the 1960s in Japan. The occurrence of such religious persecution is unthinkable in this age.
한국으로 시집 온 일본 사람은
of the 7,000 Japanese women who reside in Korea with their Korean husbands, more than 300 are victims of abduction confinement. We are gathered here today representing those victims who live in Korea. We are very much aware that the Japanese ambassador in Korea is working hard every day to promote the development of Japan and friendship between Korea and Japan and protected citizens, thereby promoting peace in Asia.
날마다 고생이 많으신 것으로 압니다.
We are Japanese nationals married to Koreans living in Korea as members of this society and as members of the Unification Church. There are currently approximately 7,000 Japanese women living with their Korean husbands
살고 있는 일본 부인에게 약 7,000명이 있습니다. 이러한 이상과 질병의 피해는 저의 생활을 파하시고 가게 하는 일이 저희에게 일어나고 있습니다.
activities of abducting and
일본에 있어서 저희 교회의
신체를 in Japan.
납치감
forcing them to change their faith. They've been occurring for more than 40 years.
이미 40명 이상 거죠. 발생되어 왔는데
this includes Japanese women living in Korea with their Korean husbands. Who became victims when they visited Japan. Until now, we endured this silently. Thinking it was just our own personal issue. Now, though, many of our children have grown to an age where they can understand what is going on in society. So we can no longer remain silent. We now make public the reality of the unjust persecution that we are receiving in Japan because of our faith and the ongoing suffering that continues to this day as we prepare a petition requesting action for you to protect our human rights. We ask, we sincerely ask the ambassador for your deep understanding and support representing regarding this matter.
Chikako
Tanaka, representative of the Association of Victims of Abduction, Confinement, and Forced Conversion, and 323 others. In May 1989, my uncle, who was a member of the Communist Party in Japan and who opposed the Unification Church, contacted my parents in Shinagawa, Tokyo. At that time, I had to discuss with my parents the teachings of the Unification Church. The first, my first abduction, I was abducted and confined in a room 307 of the Yoshida Hotel located in Fuji Yoshida of Yamanashi Prefecture. We arrived at the Yoshida Hotel, my father's second youngest sister, Sumiko, and her husband, Hiro Sakara, were waiting for us. My father took my right arm, and my aunt took my left arm, and dragged me into the room. My parents took turns contacting a Christian minister several times during the day and conveyed to each other the instructions they received from that minister. For 4 days and more than 10 hours a day, Reverend Kyoko of Kawasaki demanded that I give up my faith in the Unification Church. There was a toilet and a bathroom in this hotel room, but it had no windows. There are about 300 victims of abduction and confinement. 50 of them have come here today as representatives. In Japan, we joined the Unification Church and believe that Reverend Sung Myung Moon to be the second coming of the Lord, the Savior, and Messiah. We also believe that Korea is the third Israel and the father nation that will bring salvation to the world. This is why we came to Korea, according to God's will. We have collected signatures around the country to support these victims. We have here 11,057 signatures. You can see the signatures here. So why did we come here in front of the Japanese embassy? It's because these victims, if any of us here, should try to go to Japan to visit our home and nephew. There is a possibility that we could be abducted and confined. It is this because there will be people planning the abduction and confinement. These people cannot go to Japan. Here are the Mrs. Erika and Mrs. Tanaka entering the Japanese embassy. We would have liked to have had the people we were planning to arrange for many more women who wanted to come here to demonstrate, but because this is in front of an embassy, 50 was the maximum number that the police would allow. And so after prior discussion with the police, it was agreed that the police would allow 50 to make this demonstration.
Sisters, how are you today? Well, today is going to be easy for me. I get to speak English. You know, about a year ago, our two parents asked me to go to Japan and manage the situation there. At that time, it was a very difficult time because the police were conducting quite an extensive investigation of our church. They actually have had nearly 10,000 law enforcement officers investigating our church. And they were conducting arrests of our church members. And they were raiding our churches, not just one or two places, but many, many. And during this situation, Father asked me to go and take a look at the situation and manage the problem there. And so, given that mission, I went to go do my job and went to go look at the situation in Japan. At that time, the government, as well as our enemies, communists and Christian ministers, of course, Christian ministers, they dislike our church very much because they believe that we are heretics. And as you know, Christianity has a long history of exterminating heretics from the time of the original division in the theology in the Arian debate, where the Arians believed that Jesus Christ was a man and not a god. So from then they pretty much killed those Arians because they disagreed. They were preaching heresy. And of course, you know about the Inquisition, and you know that during the Holocaust in Germany, the Catholic Church pretty much stayed very quiet as millions of people were being exterminated. And so we understand that in the history of Christianity, there is this tendency to become very extreme in persecuting quote-unquote heretical organizations. And in Japan, the Christian ministers have proclaimed us to be heretics, and as a result, they have been very extreme in trying to persecute our church, including lobbying to the government. The communists also in Japan have for a long time been our enemies, because we very successfully, through our VOC movement, resisted the communists' infiltration of Japanese society and succeeded in preventing many of their leaders from becoming elected into the Diet and Parliament. As a result, the Communist Party declared that they're going to make it their mission to destroy the Unification Church. Now, it is these two groups who manufactured the term spiritual sales. And by manufacturing that term, they lobbied with the government to claim that we are engaged in spiritual sales and we are engaged in fraudulent activities. And they use those accusations to get the government to persecute us. Now, Well, these are somewhat serious charges. I mean, commercial violation of law is a legal violation if it's true. Well, we can get to that later. But I had a chance to take a look at the situation in Japan. And what I've seen is I've visited over 70 churches, and I've talked to the brothers and sisters who have donated large amounts of money. In Japan, you go to any church in Japan, you'll find brothers and sisters who donated $1 million, $2 million, $3 million, $8 million, $10 million. Even you'll meet a sister who donated $100 million. And I've met all these people, because I've been out in the field, in the front line, talking with our brothers and sisters. And then I asked them, what moved you to donate so much money? And you will see all of our brothers and sisters, there are so many cases, they'll tell you their ancestors came to them and told them to do it. Our church in Japan is an extremely spiritual church with a very high level of spirituality. Our brothers and sisters, they live the word. They live their faith. They breathe their faith. And the spirit world lives together with them. It's not something which they conceptualize, like many of our brothers and sisters in the West or even here in Korea. It's something they see and feel every day because they see the miracles and spirit world working through them and with them in all their activities. So if you meet the brothers and sisters in Japan, you've met Japanese brothers and sisters. Have you found one that's dishonest? No, they're all extremely pure people. They're great brothers and sisters. As honest as you can get. Unselfish, completely dedicated to God. That's the reality. So the communists, I don't know how much you know about communists, but one thing which the communists believe is they believe that God does not exist. And so since they believe that God does not exist, they believe that spirit world doesn't exist. So if we have church members who are donating because the spirit world told them to do it, we must be a fraudulent organization. The unification church must be committing fraud. That is the basis of their logic. It's ridiculous. It's stupid. The government is a farce. And let me tell you why I think and know that the Japanese government's persecution and accusation against us is a farce. It's because look at what they have done to the unification church members. Let me ask you a question. Kidnapping, is this a crime? Which crime is more serious? Commercial violation of law or kidnapping? Let me ask you this. Murder, is murder a crime? Which is more serious? Commercial violation of law or murder? Rape, is rape a crime? What's a more serious crime, commercial violation of law or rape? Let me ask you one question. Why in the world is the government spending 10,000 officers, billions of dollars to investigate our church, and the only thing they can come up with is quote-unquote commercial violation of law, when they are refusing to investigate a kidnapping business which has kidnapped and tortured for over 4,000 of its own citizens? Would you like to answer that for me? What plausible answer is there to that question? It's plain and simple. The government policy of Japan is to persecute the Unification Church. That is their policy. That is why they are spending ridiculous amounts of Japanese taxpayer money to investigate us while they do not take seriously any of these charges of kidnapping, for which we have tremendous amounts of evidence. You know, Mr. Goto, he was in prison. He was kidnapped and incarcerated illegally for 12 and a half years. You saw his picture, right, when he was finally got out. He looked like a Holocaust victim. You know that he filed a criminal lawsuit against his kidnappers? You know what the prosecution did? They declined to prosecute. They declined to prosecute. They said there was insufficient evidence of a crime. Is this justice? This is the reality of what our church faces in Japan. We are under systematic persecution by the government in conjunction with the communist attorneys and with the Christian ministers. You know, one of the ministers who is conducting these kidnappings, over 50% of his congregation are our church members who he kidnapped and forced to join his church. And you know what? He's making them donate a lot of money to him. And you know what else? You know how much the Christian ministers and the communist attorneys get paid to kidnap one of our brothers and sisters? Per kidnapping, they get between $30,000 to $100,000. And if you don't have $30,000 or $100,000, they won't kidnap for you. And then you know what the communist attorneys do? Once they kidnap the person and they force them to leave the church, they make that person sue the church for the donations which he or she made. And then they get 30%. This is a business. This is a kidnapping business. This is a trade in human misery. This is what's happening. These are the lies which are being spewed from those organizations. This is the bullcrap, I'm sorry to use that word, which is on the internet. It's a pack of lies. And the accusations of the government is a farce. We are being persecuted in Japan. That's the reality. My proof is all those victims. We have collected over 300 legal affidavits in Korea from the victims. In Japan, we have already collected 60. We have over 350 in process. That's only a start. We have over 4,300 victims. These are legal affidavits. They are usable in court. We filed about 9 of the cases at that time when we had to the UN, Human Rights Commission. Upon receiving those cases and those documents and interviewing those victims, the UN Human Rights Committee accepted this issue as an issue of human rights violation. With just 9 cases. Now, my sister has been working tirelessly in the U.S., meeting congressmen, explaining to them this issue of kidnapping. She's currently met over 30 current congressmen in the U.S. Congress. And we feel very confidently, she met all the congressmen in the Human Rights Committee, and we feel very confidently that we are very close to getting a congressional hearing on this issue. It's a very real possibility. As you have seen, the press have reported on this issue. We've shown them the documents. They've talked to the victims. They know it's real. We will send all this documentation and all this material to all the international media, CNN, BBC, CBS, NBC, all the international media. Brothers and sisters, we are being persecuted because of our faith. And you have brothers and sisters who are dying, who are being tortured, who are being raped because of their faith. They are living their commitment. They're living their faith on a day-to-day basis, not talking about their faith, living it, really sacrificing their lives for the whole world. These are your brothers and sisters. These are really the saints and martyrs of our church. These are people we really need to embrace and uplift. They are our heroes. They really set the standard of how we should seek to live our lives. Standard of faith we should have to bring our faith to the entire world. Because what we have been taught is truly, truly great. There really is no better understanding of God than which is taught through the principle. None. You know, I know you've heard this before. But let me just say it again. You know, Christianity is a very wonderful faith and a wonderful religion, and Jesus Christ brought a great deal of enlightenment to the world. But he died on the cross. And because he died on the cross, the faith and the theology is very incomplete. It's in many ways kind of irrational if you really get into the workings of the theology and the practice of Christianity in the major churches, like even the Catholic Church. The fundamental problem comes from the understanding of Christ and his role and what his relationship with God is. You know, in Christian theology, basically, you have the concept of the Trinity. I don't know, how many of you understand Christianity? You know the concept of the Trinity? Three is one and one is three. God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. So you have one God, but there are three gods, and three gods, but it's one God. So, you know, the Muslims kind of say, okay, Christians, you say you're monotheistic and you believe in God, but what is it? You believe in three gods or one? That's the criticism they make of Christianity. Christianity didn't like that so much, so they said, okay, we're monotheistic and we don't like your criticism, so we're going to kill you. And they did. We went to the Crusades. I mean, that's the reality, right? You can't rewrite history. So that's one contradiction. The other contradiction is, when you study Christianity, what do they teach you about God's divinity? Christianity teaches you that the divinity of God cannot be known. This is one of the fundamental pillars of Christian theology. And because man is so small and so finite and so much of the world, it is impossible for such a creature to understand the omnipotence and the infinite nature and the eternal nature of God the Creator. But then again, Jesus Christ said, God is my Father, and we're supposed to love him, and we're supposed to try to emulate him. But if I can never know him, how can I love him and emulate him? I mean, this could drive me nuts. This is the nature of Christian theology, if you really study it. That's why when people really study Christian theology, once they go from being a lay person to being a Christian theologian or professional, many people go agnostic because it doesn't make sense. Come on. You want to get into the nuances of theology? Why don't you look at Christian theology? You want to nitpick about that? Oh, I think our theology is quite a bit more rational than that. I mean, we come very clearly. We explain what the purpose of man and woman is. Four Position Foundation, the role of the true parents in changing the lineage. You know, we explain very clearly what it is they want us to do, that they want us to inherit God's divinity. And what is God's divinity? It's true love. What is true love? It's a love which can bring even Satan to voluntary surrender. This theology that we have, this truth, this is the ultimate truth. It really completes what Jesus Christ started, the process of salvation. It substantiates it. This is the truth that we have from our true parents. And it is because we have this ultimate truth, the truth from God, the truth that Satan, the devil, has tried to keep from all of humanity. This is why we are being persecuted. This is why we are being defamed. It is the work of the devil. There is evil in the world. And the evil is doing everything it can to prevent God's word and God's truth from being revealed to all the people of the world. This is the reality, brothers and sisters. This is the reality. We are being persecuted. We are at war with the devil. This is why we need your support. We really need you to understand the issues at play today, the real issues, not the issues which the people who are defaming us are saying, because they're a bunch of liars. It's crap. The real issues, the real truth. Look at the real evidence. Look at the evidence of these 4,300 victims who have been tortured, molested, killed, raped, without any justice. Then ask yourself, what do you believe? And if you believe what I'm saying, what are you going to do about it? You're going to just sit back and let them do this? No. You should help. You should protest this evil. You should profess your faith. You should educate all the people in the world. Reveal the truth. Declare our true parents. And restore this world. Thank you very much.
Brothers and sisters, let's give it up for Kuk Jin-young, a true warrior. Hey. Oh my goodness. Let's bow our heads in prayer. Final prayer. Dearest most beloved Heavenly Father, dearest most beloved true parents, we thank you so much for this day. Because Father, we want to understand our brothers and sisters in Japan. We want to understand what they have gone through for the last 40 years as they sacrificed everything for the sake of the world providence. Nobody in the whole Unification Church can claim that. Everybody bows their head to those saints, those martyrs of our faith, who profess the name of true parents wherever they go. Father, that is the ideal, the standard from which we will learn our faith. A faith that is not afraid of injustice. A faith that is not afraid of what is popular. A faith that is not afraid of intimidation. A faith that is true, that is rooted in a deep love for God and humanity. A faith that is rooted in the redemption of sin and freedom from sin to the everlasting life with you. And Father, today we want to remember our brothers and sisters because they are still suffering in Japan, and this problem is not fully dealt with. Father, we pray that all of the spirit world can be mobilized. That all our brothers and sisters around the world will not only become conscious of this as some human rights violation, but as a violation of them, of their own family. For our brothers and sisters in Japan, our family. They are our sisters and our wives. They are our mothers and our daughters. And if we have any true compassion as unificationists, as people who have found the returning Christ, then we will stand up for them. We will seek justice for them so that they may be free from the chains which they are bound by, the chains of evil, the chains of the people that are using Satan's, under Satan's dominion to work against such saints. Father, we want to truly pray for them today. But we don't want to just have a shallow faith and just pray for them. We want to step up. We want to step up and support them. We want to support them in every single way possible. Father, we want to be able to distribute all the pamphlets to the nation of Korea, the nation of America, all the nations, to understand what is truly happening, that the Unification Church is being systematically attacked, persecuted, and an attempt at extermination because of our faith. Father, let us find justice this day. Let us find your great hand of wisdom, and let us work with your mercy and your love so that we can overcome this falsity, this evil, by the power of truth, by the power of goodness, and by the power of true love. We thank you so much, Father, that you join us from every corner of the world, that you join us even on the internet. And we pray that we may stand together as a community of faith that believes in true parents as the Messiah and Savior. We don't apologize for our faith. We are unapologetic about our faith. And we are proud to be who we are. We stand up for the brothers and sisters who risk their lives every day to go out and fight for us. And we step up this day to become more like them. We thank you so much and pray all these things with a deep and profound gratitude and an everlasting love. Pray this in our own names and in the name of our most beloved true parents. Ajou.
And let us offer our heartfelt appreciation, gratitude to God and our true parents with a standing bow. Kyungbae. Baro. And now please turn to the person next to you and let us make the unification symbol. So give and receive action. Four position foundation. May you inherit the true love of God. And then please give that person a hug or a high five or all of the above. And brothers and sisters, we want to thank you so much for coming. Please do let your friends and relatives and guests know that we do have an international service here, that they can come and join us at 6 o'clock. Again, thank you so much. God bless. May you have a fantastic week. Thank you. Ah, Jew.